Hi friends, in this video, I will show you how to graft tomatoes on an eggplant or brinjal, and you will see what actually happens when you use this technique. I will also answer the question whether it's necessary to graft tomatoes on an eggplant and when is the appropriate time to do so. Let's get to it. You may ask, why the need to graft tomatoes? Grafting of tomatoes is often recommended as a preventive measure for certain soil-borne pathogens such as bacterial wilt and nematodes. The choice of the rootstock, which is a part of the plant that stays in the soil, is critical to reap the benefits of grafting. A tolerant tomato cultivar can be used, or as will be shown in this video, eggplant or brinjal also works. To graft tomatoes on an eggplant, you need an eggplant and of course a tomato plant. If you want to get more tomatoes, then it is best to use young plants or seedlings from both plants. Cut the seedling of the eggplant at a low level, about 1 inch above the last node. This will prevent vigorous regrowth of the eggplant. Next is to cut the tomato seedling. You need to make sure that the stems of the two plants are of the same thickness. Use a sharp knife or blade to shape the bottom of the tomato stem into a wedge. This is why this method is called the wedge grafting. It is also known as cleft grafting. There are other grafting techniques, but this works best for tomatoes as it ensures maximum contact between the tomato scion and the eggplant rootstock. Make a vertical cut right through the middle of the eggplant rootstock, about the same length as the wedge of the tomato scion, and insert the tomato into it as shown. Push it down so the wedge is completely covered by the eggplant tissue. Hold the graft in place with a grafting clip or tape. You can also use zip ties, as I've shown in some of my previous videos. Link in the description. Cover the grafted seedling with a transparent plastic. This is necessary if your seedlings are on a nursery bed, as it maintains the right humidity for faster healing and better survival. After 6 days, the plastic cover can be removed since the graft would have healed. Now, let's find out what happened after grafting the tomato on the eggplant. I transplanted into a bigger container 10 days after grafting and kept it in partial shade to minimize transplanting shock. 20 days after grafting, the tomato had grown more leaves and was tilted to one side. This meant it was time for staking, so I did just that and moved it into full sunlight. Tomatoes grow best with good lighting. The eggplant has started growing a small branch. I decided to let it grow to see if it could produce some fruits. I provided the same care and nutrition as I give my tomato plants. By day 40, the tomato plant had grown into a full plant and had even started flowering. On the other hand, the eggplant was growing rather slowly, and it didn't look like it was going to flower anytime soon. I pruned off some of the lower leaves of the tomato and sprayed it with potassium nitrate. On day 64, some fruits had formed on the tomato plant. It was exciting to see these fruits. The leaves looked a bit curled, but I knew this wasn't the problem. If you want to know why tomato leaves curl and when to be worried, check out my video on the topic with a link in the video description or from the end screen video. 80 days after grafting, the first tomato fruit was ready to be harvested. I was wondering what it would taste like, so I didn't hesitate to take a bite. The taste was as good as my regular non-grafted tomatoes. The eggplant still looks small, and didn't appear like it was going to produce any fruit soon. So there you have it. We have successfully grafted tomato on an eggplant and produced some tasty fruits. Give it a try and let me know how it goes. Comments and questions are welcome. Smash the like button and share it if you enjoyed this video. Have a nice day and see you in our next video. Until then, it's adios.